Jury has the case in the Josh Young murder trial. Closing arguments just wrapped up. WLKY's Matt McCutcheon joins us live now outside of the Judicial Center with the arguments from both sides. Matt.
The case went to the jury just about half an hour ago. It all started this morning with those closing arguments, each lasting about 1 hour in this case. Both sides agreeing that Josh Gaucher was sort of the ringleader in all of this, but they differ on Josh Young's involvement. That's the person standing trial. Here's a look at video as soon as he entered the courtroom. It was just moments later when those closing arguments, lasting about an hour from the prosecution and an hour from the defense, took place. They all basically centered around different scenarios, but at the end of the day, with no substantial physical evidence in this case, it really comes down to what the witnesses say. Both sides took a stab at one witness in particular who said that Gaucher and Young were with her in Alabama, at which point she says Young admitted to killing 14-year-old Trace Wicker. Here's what she had to say.
Young told Angelique that he killed Trey with a slugger. And not only do you have Gaucher's word for it, or Angelique's word for it, but you have Gaucher, again, slipping up on the stand. She said she wasn't drinking, but in fact, she previously said she was drinking. We talked about what happens when you mix whatever she was taking, that she claimed she was taking by force. That wasn't her fault. She can't remember it. It's all a blur, except for one gleaming moment. She was totally sober, and this horrible version of events comes out.
Closing arguments for each lasted about an hour, wrapping up just about 2 weeks worth of testimony that jurors, all 12 of them, have had to listen to in this case. Now we understand they will be having lunch and will spend the afternoon deliberating this case. What isn't clear is when a verdict could come down. That could be later today, but there is the possibility of this stretching into next week. Now we do know the judge says that if there is no verdict decision tonight, that the jurors will be sequestered, but it isn't clear if they'll resume work on the case tomorrow on Saturday, or if they'll be back here again Monday. I'll be back inside the courtroom and have updates for you throughout the day on Twitter, as well as WLKY.com and beginning at 5. For now, reporting live in downtown this noon, I'm Matt McCutcheon, WLKY News.